from Skycity Theatre in Auckland, New Zealand, and streaming live right around the globe, this is the grand final of Miss Universe New Zealand 2015. Ladies and gentlemen, they are your finalists in Miss Universe New Zealand 2015. And now, please welcome your hosts for the evening, Stephen McIvor and Sonia Gray.
Wow. Wow, wow, wow. Hey?
Beautiful.
Beautiful. Beautiful. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the grand final of Miss Universe New Zealand 2015. And a beautiful. Good evening to you, Sonia.
Oh, thanks. You know, it's not often you get to dress up in sparkles and sequins, is it?
Mm-hmm.
I'm loving it. It's such a pleasure to be here. We have 20 amazing finalists, a beautiful audience, and what's really exciting is so many people around the world watching right
now.
Oh,
yes, modern technology. Well, due to the digital miracle, it's a kumaster to you in Manila. G'day to you in Australia. And good morning, Vietnam. And I'm not going to take it any further than that because, you know, I'm probably going to blow it, but that's the way it goes.
Kia ora, Vietnam. Kia ora, Vietnam. Kia ora to all of you around the world. It is going to be a spectacular show wherever you are. Now, if you are watching us online, then why not click on the souvenir program on the website, nextmissnz.com. Mm-hmm. Download it. It's free. Then we'll feel like you're right here with us.
Yeah, we are here, right?
We are here.
We're here. Look, it's not just us who've got a job tonight. We do have five judges who, with the help of you at home, the public, will vote the unenviable task of taking 20, that's right, 20, down to the very heartbreaking number of five. So, and one, down to one, 5-1. So let's meet the judges, shall we?
And our first judge tonight is Ivana Patterson. She's a makeup consultant, founder of Head to Heels, and a former director of the Miss Universe New Zealand Consortium. Ivana Patterson. Next to Ivana, Steve Broadwood, a young man who's no stranger to being judged himself, having been in the top 10 of both Idol and X Factor. And next to Steve, a lady who was a judge on that series of Idol, Megan Alatini. She was the original pop star, she's a TV personality, and now she flies. Our first international judge tonight, Ben Chan, the founder and owner of Bench, with over 1,000 stores across Asia. He kind of knows what women want. And our final judge, MJ Lastimosa, Miss Universe Philippines 2014. Now an actress and a TV star in her own right, and more than qualified in tonight's endeavours. Ladies and gentlemen, our 2015 judging panel.
We have an amazing show coming up for you guys, and it's been a big year for Miss Universe New Zealand. To tell us a little bit more about it, please welcome the CEO of Miss Universe New Zealand, Nigel Godfrey.
Oh, you're back. Okay. Welcome back, Nigel.
Enemy glasses. Oh.
There we go. You don't have to read anything, so you just have to talk to us. It's quite simple. All right, tell us how the year started, my old friend.
Well, now do I? Yes, I should tell you how the year started. Look, you might have known, because it went pretty viral on Facebook, we had a caravan, Miss Universe New Zealand. We had a caravan. Here's the picture, Miss Universe New Zealand caravan. And some absolute lowlife in Tauranga stole it. Is it there? Look, that is, we used to call that Missy. So what I want you to do, if you're watching at home, look over your neighbour's fence, all right? Yes, we think it's around Waihee, around Tauranga. Look over your neighbour's fence. If you find it, I've got $2,500 for you. I want it back. Right. Anyway, moving on. Yes, what else happened?
You probably know this already. This is your third year. Does it get easier?
It gets bigger, okay?
Well, that's good. That's good.
As we progress, we get bigger. Obviously, we take everybody overseas on the retreat. The sponsors come on board. It's very, very exciting this year. We're going to talk about that a little bit later. The show gets bigger, more people to deal with, more people running through Stiletto Camp, but it's great.
Yeah, but rewarding too. Hard work, but rewarding.
The most rewarding part of this is the change that we see in the lives of the young women who come on board to do the show. It really is, we talk about it being a journey, it really is a fantastic journey. And of course, there's the flip side of it, where we raise quite a lot of money for charity as well.
Here we do too, and one of those young ladies will walk away with a 2015 Honda Jazz RS.
Drive away, in fact.
Did I say?
We might let her drive away tonight. We might just let her enjoy the party instead of Sky City. We'll give her the keys a little bit later.
Beautiful week cast. That's a very special major prize here for Miss Universe New Zealand 2015. All right, thank you, Nige.
Thank you very much.
I appreciate your help and the hard work. I know you're going to chat with Rachel, Miss Universe New Zealand 2014, a little bit later on. And, of course, we'll see Nige in the second half with the results, because he's the numbers guy. That was Nigel Godfrey, CEO of Miss Universe.
Multi-talented, isn't he?
Well, he's Mr. Show Business, really. Well, that's what he tells me anyway. I think that's how it works. Yeah, so let's just move on, shall we, and get this party started.
Yeah. Now, Stiletto Camp. Who's heard of Stiletto Camp? Good, good. Cool name. Now, this is the first time the organisation sees the girls. So, this year, 200 contestants registered. Around 120 were seen. This was their story.
Bay of Plenty,
Dunedin,
Puhoi,
from Auckland.
Get ready.
This is Stiletto
Camp.
Lots of listening, lots of learning, lots of fun. The one thing I love about that, Sonia, is the name, Stiletto Camp.
It works, doesn't it?
It does
really
work.
And the girls love it. You know why they love it? Because it's the first part of the journey. We talk about the journey a lot, but it's an amazing journey. Next year, these camps start in March, in March, and straight after the show tonight, registration begins for Miss Universe New Zealand 2016.
So I can already see some eyes light up.
Yeah,
I can see some eyes light up in the audience. That's very cool. They know they're on the telly. That's their most important thing. You know, it's hard to believe that, but Miss Universe here in New Zealand has been going almost 60 years.
60.
Almost 60 years. So it's closing in on its diamond anniversary. But the one special thing about this show, like it has done in the last few years, is they have an international retreat. Oh, yes. They go on an international retreat, and this year they discovered, and we all will discover a little bit later on, how beautiful, how enchanting the country of Philippines really is. It's beautiful, yeah. So that's very good. And the one thing they do have there, and you will know all about this.
The shopping.
Hello,
I've heard a lot about the shopping. Thanks to Bench and Vero Moda, they had a shopping spree. Amazing. Now, what they got, basically an open wallet, didn't they?
Well, I think they did all right, didn't they?
Look at that. Shop up a storm. Lots of outfits. I've talked to them a lot about this. You can see this happening right now. And what they decided when they came home was that it would be a good idea, because they're doing a parade, to actually showcase the outfits that they bought.
Actually, that's quite smart, isn't it? We've got a beauty pageant called Miss Universe New Zealand 2015. Why don't we have a parade? Should we have a parade?
Let's do it.
Let's do it. All right.
Yeah.
Okay, so now here's the interesting thing here, folks. The women have chosen what they're wearing from Bench and Vero Moda. So let's get busy. This is the Bench and Vero Moda parade.
Like it was baptized.
something. In the club with the lights off, but you actin' shy for. Come and show me that you're with it, with it, with it, with it, with it. Stop playing, now you know that I'm with it, with it, with it, with it, with it, with it. What you actin' shy for?
Just give me you, just give me you. That's all I wanna do. And if what they say is true, if it's true, I'ma give me to you. I may take a lot of stuff, guaranteed, I can back it up.
So there you have it, the Bench and Vera Moroto Parade. Give the girls a big round of applause.
They did good. They did good. Note to self, when I win the Powerball jackpot, I'm heading straight to Manila shopping up the store.
Hang on a minute. What did you say? Powerball.
Powerball. Jackpot. Millions.
Oh, shouldn't you be somewhere mucking around with coloured balls right now?
Oh, what's the time?
It's...
And those balls can't call themselves. No, I'm kidding. The draw is in very safe hands tonight, but you guys probably have a ticket for tonight's lotto draw, don't you? You might want to go and check it. So we're going to take a quick break, but don't go far, because coming up we're going to catch up with the reigning Miss Universe New Zealand, Rachel Milnes. X Factor's May Valley are here and they're going to sing for us, and there's a whole lot more.
And then we've got the swimwear collection. And later we'll see the girls in their golden gowns. Well, actually, hang on a minute. They're not golden in colour, but Ankia from Golden Gowns has, of course, designed an entire range, an entire evening wear collection for the evening. And that's all still to come on Miss Universe New Zealand, the grand final. So stay with us.
Obviously people judge a lot, but I mean, you just have to see it for yourself.
There's a lot of heart and soul and blood and sweat and tears that go into producing that service.
We got lots of produce from different parts of New Zealand.
Doesn't matter what department you are from, everybody's proud of what they do.
It's actually about stretching beyond the buildings and into the future of New Zealand.
Miss Universe New Zealand wishes to acknowledge the following platinum sponsors. Golden Gowns, making Miss Universe New Zealand stand out on the international stage. UFC Refresh, 100% coconut water, giving you 100% natural rehydration. UFC Refresh. We stay at the Quadrant Hotel and Suites, where style and sophistication spend the night together. Own the night with the world's best-looking champagne. It's Beaujolais pour moi. And now we'll take you back to Skycity Theatre for the Miss Universe New Zealand Grand Final 2015.
Welcome back. Well, as you've seen, we have 20 sensational finalists tonight. So these guys behind me, the judges, really have their work cut out for them. But remember, it's a 50-50 split.
They've just finished tweeting, all of them. They quickly put their phones away, tweeting, Instagram, Snapchatting, the whole nine yards. Of course, the public vote also makes up that half of the 50-50. So you at home can vote. And that's very, very important. So it's quite a simple process, really. You go to the contestants page or go to the Miss Universe New Zealand Facebook page, simply click on and vote away to your heart's content.
And those votes are just $1 each. And remember, $1 from every bundle purchased goes to Variety, the children's charity.
Yeah, all righty. Now, someone who impressed you at home last year and the esteemed judges was the current and reigning Miss Universe New Zealand. Please, a warm round of applause, a big round of applause for Miss Universe New Zealand 2014, Rachel Milnes.
Rachel, come and take a seat. Come and sit in the psychiatrist's chair after a year. Take a seat. So, it's been quite a year, hasn't it?
It has been. It's been a very full-on year, but no, it's been just such a highlight of my life, so thank you.
Right, I'm going to take you back. I'm going to take you back to, well, about this time, about an hour later than this time last year,
yes.
When I think this... Yeah, this happened. I don't know if... Yes, there you go. Do you remember that? I mean, what went through your mind when you became Miss Universe New Zealand?
I think shock, really. I mean, I didn't really know what had hit me. I didn't expect to have won. Competing, it was my third time competing for the title of Miss Universe New Zealand. So for me, I'd worked really, really hard, and I guess it was just, you know, that moment that I'd worked so hard for. So I was just over the moon, yeah.
Right, so we were running a little later than some of the other countries, and you didn't have much time, did you, to prepare before we sent you off to Florida?
Yes, to Florida.
Okay.
Durrell.
What was Florida like? I think we might see a little bit of you in Florida. You were on that big stage. It was a big show, wasn't it?
It was huge. A lot bigger than here. I mean, Florida was so hot. It was winter over there. But of course, it was like our summer. So it was so much fun. I made so many friends. Really got on with my roommate, Miss Great Britain. And it was just surreal. Again, I mean, it made me grow so much as a person. It was my first time overseas alone.
And I know that, I mean, there's 90-odd contestants. So I think we can see some of that footage now from Florida. And you have to, like, get out there. And you have to do what you... There you go, Rachel Milnes. There she is, Rachel Milnes, New Zealand. How was that? You're going to... I think the television audience is around about... 500 million to a billion.
So surreal, isn't
it? Did it go through your head?
You try not to think about it. I mean, for me, you just try and have fun. So, I mean, just like tonight, what the girls will be doing backstage, you try and have fun with it. You're with your friends and you're just really representing your country. And so I was so proud to represent New Zealand.
And, of course, you've just come back. You got back, yesterday from Thailand. And you went and presented the check to the Father Ray Foundation down there.
I did.
What was it like going back to Thailand after being there on retreat?
Well, for me, Thailand feels like my second home now. I've said that a lot. And I guess, I mean, it was my first time leaving New Zealand and going to Thailand with Miss Universe New Zealand. So, again, very hot over there, but the people are just so friendly. And it's so surreal. So, I mean, you go over there and pageants are huge over there. So, I mean, everywhere you go, people notice you.
And I think we'll see a little bit of that later with the Philippines. If you had to give a little bit of advice... Just lastly, a little bit of advice to the person who takes out the crown tonight.
Yep.
What would you say?
To have fun, keep an open mind, and to just really, I guess, just look at it like it's an experience of a lifetime. Only a handful of people really get to do it. And you're representing New Zealand, so just stand up there, stand proud, and just be yourself.
Well, Rachel, you have represented New Zealand admirably over the last year. as you take your spot in the centre of the stage, ladies and gentlemen, for the last time, Rachel Milnes as Miss Universe New Zealand.
Just glamorous. One more time as she takes her final walk, you might say. Well, as we've already mentioned, this year's top 20 go to the Philippines on an incredible five-star, nine-night retreat. And we've really got to say, an enormous thank you to the TPB, the Tourism Promotions Board in the Philippines, for making it happen. It was really a special week.
We didn't get there, unfortunately, I know. But of course, one of the reasons for that trip is to shoot a swimwear section. Now, New Zealand is one of the only countries in the Miss Universe family, which numbers 90 countries, I think, that doesn't feature on stage. It stays on the beach, and that's cool, isn't it?
Well, we are a beach country.
We are a beach.
It's as simple as that, and I cannot wait for summer. Ladies and gentlemen, with stills by Alan Raga, here is the swimwear collection, part one.
Krishma Govind there. And this is Renita Lau. Renita chose the black bench one piece for her swimwear shot, and she looks fantastic. Now we have Lizzie Baird, Elizabeth Baird from Wellington. Looks very comfortable in front of the camera, does Elizabeth? Wearing the bench bodywear. Now, Gabrielle Manaloto, Filipino-New Zealander. Again, wearing the bench one piece for her swimwear shot in the swimwear calendar. This is Sean Boot. Sean shot her swimwear at Nalasuam Island. Sophie Batten. She takes a great picture with the Fujifilm Instax. That's who Sean actually works for. Sophie Batten. Sophie Batten. And this is Caitlin Wood, her last year at university. And she shot her swimwear at the J Park in Cebu. Caitlin Wood. Becky Hingston, Becky's second time in Miss Universe New Zealand, from freezing south, but it certainly wasn't south, freezing at J-Park. And this is Evelyn Dore, our youngest competitor. Chose to wear the bench bodywear for her swimwear shot. She was a little nervous, she told me, but you wouldn't know it. There's the lovely Evelyn Dore. Ella Wilson. The lovely Ella.
So that's the first part of the swimwear collection, beautifully shot by Alan Raga.
Tell me, Stephen, have you got a favourite yet?
I don't think we're allowed to. It's called being impartial and having host responsibility, so I'll say nothing.
So diplomatic. Of course, you guys at home are allowed to choose your favourite. So wherever you are in the world, make sure you head to Facebook and vote for your favourite contestant. Votes are just $1 each. And for every bundle sold, Miss Universe New Zealand will donate $1 to Variety, the children's charity.
Variety do an incredible job, and we'll see and hear a little bit more about that this evening. But right now it's time for some entertainment. Earlier this year, starting right here on this very stage, there was a little show called X Factor, and from that show, two performers were quite literally put together to form a group.
And they went on to sign with Sony Music. Very, very soon, they'll be releasing their first EP. How's that? So, here they are, Abby and Hannah. You know them as May Valley.
Hey, guys. Hi, it's so good to be here. So nice to be here. Before we sing, we'd just like to let you all know that we have been working really hard on music these last few months, and we have an EP coming out really soon, and we also have a single out on iTunes on Friday, so we'll just let you guys know that.
Woo, buy it. we're going to sing one of our favourite covers by one of our favourite artists, Taylor Swift.
It's called Wildest Dreams, and I hope you enjoy it.
He said, let's get out of this town, drive out of the city, away from the crowds. I said, heaven can help me now, nothing lasts forever. But this is gonna take me down. He's so tall and handsome as hell. He's so bad, but he does it so well. I can see the end as it begins. My one condition is, say you'll remember me, standing in a nice dress, staring at the sunset, babe, red lips and rosy cheeks. Say you'll see me again, even if it's just in your wildest dreams. Oh, do. His hands are in my hair, his clothes are in my room, and his voice is a familiar sound. Nothing lasts forever, but this is getting good now. He's so tall and handsome as hell. He's so bad, but he does it so well. And when we've had our very last kiss, my one request it is, say you'll remember me, standing in a nice dress, staring at the sunset, babe, red lips and rosy cheeks. Say you'll see me again, even if it's just in your wildest dreams. Oh, oh, wildest dreams. Oh, oh. You see me in hindsight, tangled up with you all night, burning when you leave me. I bet these memories follow you around, follow you around. Say you'll remember me, standing in a nice dress, staring at the sunset, babe, red lips and rosy cheeks. Say you'll see me again, even if it's just pretend. Say you'll remember me, standing in a nice dress, staring at the sunset, babe, red lips and rosy cheeks. Say you'll see me again, even if it's just in your wildest dreams. Oh, oh, wildest dreams. Oh,
ladies and gentlemen, May Valley. Now, the Miss Universe New Zealand CEO, Nigel, of course, worked with you guys on X Factor. And when he was in the Philippines, he went to the world-famous Allegra Guitar Factory and he bought you a little prezi each.
Aww.
There you go.
Thanks, Nigel.
Now, you guys have had an amazing year. You're about to release an EP. How does this all feel? Is it crazy? Is it fun? Is it scary?
It feels kind of unbelievable. Like, going from X Factor, and it was kind of like a big... Like, we just had no idea what we were doing or where we were going with life. But as soon as we got into the studio, we kind of felt the momentum going again. And it's just been so good. We're pretty happy.
Awesome. Are you ready to be stars again?
I think, yeah, we're definitely on the road to get there. So this is just another step as well. So yeah. we're so thankful.
Well, it's a good step, and I'm certainly going to be downloading that new EP. Ladies and gentlemen, one more time for May Valley.
Thank you.
Now, speaking of downloading, if you're watching this at home and you'd like a copy of the souvenir program, it's so easy. All you have to do is head to our website or Facebook page, and it's there to download for free. Almost as good as being here with us, isn't it?
Nah, not quite. No, not quite. The atmosphere in this is, there's just a little bit of a buzz. I'm starting to get a little tingle down my back.
The magic's happening,
the
isn't it?
The magic is happening. So without further ado, let's head back to the Philippines for part two of the swimwear collection.
Part two with Nikki Slater. Now, Nikki is a primary school teacher in Wellington,
What's to tell the kids on Tuesday, methinks? This is Samantha McClung. And Sam had her photo shoot, again, as you can see, on Nullarsuin Island. What a place to do a photo shoot. Sam McClung. Rachel Anea, also studying to become a primary school teacher. There weren't teachers like this in my day. And Rachel chose the bench bodywear for her swimwear shot, and she wears it well. And Layla there, Layla Doll on the right. Layla loved the shopping in the Philippines, just absolutely adored it. And there she is in her swimwear, the black bench one piece. Hannah Henderson, no stranger to the water, Hannah. She's a surf instructor. And again, we were out on Nullarsuin Island for her photo shoot. This is Monique Thomas Long. And Monique chose to be photographed in the beautiful bench bodywear down at J Park in Cebu. This is May Barry. May from Puhoi, long way from Puhoi, down at the J Park in Cebu. She just loved doing her swimwear shoot, she told me afterwards. This is Olivia McCabe from Fielding. Olivia, a week before, had never flown. She looks like the accomplished traveler now. Alima Rahman. Here's the lovely Alima at Pangalau Island. And Jordan Ratu. Loving the camera, Jordan. Jordan Ratu. Here they are, ladies and gentlemen, and there they are. Our top 20 finalists. Jordan, Alima, Olivia, May, Monique, Hannah, Layla, Rachel, Sammy, Nikki, Ella, Evelyn, Becky, Caitlin, Sophie, Sean, Gabby, Lizzie, Renita, and Karishma. Your top 20 in their swimwear.
So there you are, we've seen them all 20 contestants in their bench swimwear on locations in the enchanting Philippines. Question, how do we get at that gig next year?
Oh, you read my mind. It's amazing, isn't it? Bench, so beautiful.
Ben Chan's over there, I'll have a quick chat to him.
Okay,
carry on.
Now, the calendar. We've got to talk about the calendar. It's on sale now. Stephen's modelling it for us. Is that what you say? Yep, sort of. Sashaying.
Have
it
you
for
seen
us.
This?
20 girls, 20 months, $20 available on the website.
Hang on. Bit of a mistake. 20 months?
20 months. It's a great deal.
Okay. 20 months. All right.
You get almost 2 years worth of calendar.
What comes after December if there's 20 months?
It's January again, rolls around.
All right. As you know, voting is still open. That's the most important thing, but only for a few minutes more. Coming up now, this is, I know it's a favourite of yours at home and here in the auditorium, and it's a favourite of mine because it's where we get to see the girls in their evening wear.
Yes, Miss Universe New Zealand is once again delighted to be working with Ankia at Golden Gowns. And as she's done in previous years, she's designed the entire collection. Now, we saw them at the dress rehearsal, didn't we? And
Wow. Hello,
blown away. You guys are going to love it. It's stunning. Here are the top 20 in the evening wear parade.
Starting off the evening wear parade, Karishma Govins, wearing a soft champagne sequins dress with a low back, enhanced with pearl straps, which accentuates her petite body, and it has a small train. This is contestant number one, the lovely Karishma Govin. Contestant number two, Renita Lau. And Renita is wearing a backless, soft silk, dupioni lace, cap-sleeved with a crystal embellished belt, and she wears it well. Renita Lau, contestant number two. And I can feel your nature rising while I walk on you. And now we're meeting Elizabeth Baird.
contestant number three. She's wearing a sparkly mermaid gown in silver grey. It's embellished with sequins and diamantes. The lovely Elizabeth Baird. The stunning gowns designed by Ankia at Golden Gowns. Contestant number four, Gabrielle Manalozzo. And Gabby is wearing a black and gold number that leaves a long trail after the dress has gone. Gabrielle Manalozzo. And here we see Sean Boots. Sean is wearing a royal blue lace two-piece, a strapless top, and a sparkling beaded trim. Sean is contestant number five. This is Sophie Batten. Sophie is wearing a gold and green one shoulder piece with spaghetti straps going down her back, and it is a beautiful mermaid style finish. Sophie Batten. And now we have Caitlin Wood. What a classic that Caitlin is wearing. Caitlin's wearing a white off-the-shoulder piece with a see-through side panel that is embellished with laced flowers and hand-beaded pearls. Hand-beading there from Ankia and the team at Golden Gowns. And Becky Hingston now. Second time in the competition for Becky Hingston. Becky's wearing a rhinestone-studded mermaid gown with a sweetheart neckline and a soft tulle skirt in nude and black. Becky is contestant number eight. And contestant number nine is our youngest in the competition, Evelyn Dorr. Now, Evelyn is wearing a French navy and nude lace dress embellished with, again, hand-beaded and lace flowers. She has pearls on that dress too and a lot of sparkly Swarovski crystals. And doesn't the young Evelyn wear that beautifully? Evelyn Dorr. And our first lady in red, Ella Wilson. Ella is wearing a strapless sweetheart bodice-hugging dress with a fishtail finish. It has red undertones and a black lace bodice, which is embedded again with sequins. This is Ella Wilson. Nikki Slater. Those children at school have been looking at Miss Slater saying she's wearing a long sleeve gown with a high thigh center split and a beautiful plunging neckline. Well, the children might not be saying that. It's got a lovely blue sequin fabric and a low back, and this really is the ultimate glamour gown, worn beautifully by Nikki Slater. Samantha McClung here, wearing a beautiful classic silver side shoulder gown with stunning lace and chiffon, which just flows endlessly to the ground. Samantha McClung. And in turquoise, Rachel Ania. Rachel from Tauranga, wearing a heart-shaped neckline and a soft mesh skirt in aqua with lace motifs, again embellished with Swarovski crystals and a lovely train. This is Layla Dole. Layla again wearing a mermaid gown, I think the third mermaid gown we've seen, beautiful, in soft teal and cream with lace motifs and hand beading on the bodice and that lovely soft tulle skirt. Layla Dole, so much work has gone into these beautiful gowns by Ankia and the team at Golden Gowns. Here we have Hannah Henderson. wearing a see-through top, which is embellished with, again, lace flowers. I think lace flowers are definitely in this year. And a circular skirt with a center split and hand-beaded pearls. And it is, and Hannah is, simply stunning. And we have now Monique Thomas-Long, contestant number 16. Monique is wearing a beautiful turquoise dress. Beautifully brings out her eyes. The dress has a high side split, and as you can see, a lovely low back. That's Monique Thomas-Long. Now it's May Barry, shimmering in blue. A royal blue gown there with a side split, and the gown features an open back and one shoulder strap, and it's encrusted with diamantes and sequins. May Barry, contestant number 17. And here we have, from Fielding, Olivia McCabe. And Olivia is wearing a stunning high-necked, bejeweled gown. Look at all those sparkling jewels. And it has a plunging low back, and again, like all the contestants tonight, they wear these gowns so well. Olivia McCabe. Another lady in red, it's Alima Rahman. And Alima wearing a ruby gown with an embellished bodice, a sweetheart neckline, and it has a lovely soft train. It trails away there, just finishing the look. And that is Alima Rahman, contestant number 19. And contestant number 20, Jordan Ratu. Jordan is wearing a boat neck gown with a see-through embellished top with satin and chiffon. In the color there is called seafoam. Ladies and gentlemen, here they are. Let's hear it for all of our 20 finalists as they walk the catwalk for the last time in their evening wear. Their stunning gowns, designed, of course, by Ankia at Golden Gown. Nothing better. Perfection.
How about that? The Golden Gown Girls. One more round of applause for our Golden Girls, all 20 of them.
Queens right there.
Wow.
And that,
it is going to be so hard to choose this. Have you guys got any idea who you like right now? Did you understand any of that?
I didn't get any of that.
No. All right. Hey, shh, quiet in the corners. All right, well, the
okay,
show is...
I know who you like. That's half the show. Done and dusted. Just like that. Voting is going to be open for another 10 minutes, and then the public vote will be combined with the judges' vote. And we'll be ready for our first elimination. Yeah. We're not looking forward to that, but we will go from 20 to 11. It has to happen.
But we are going to take a little bit of a break now.
We'll see you very soon for the second half of the show a little bit later on. Enjoy.
Obviously people judge a lot, but I mean, you just have to see it for yourself.
There's a lot of heart and soul and blood and sweat and tears that go into producing that service.
We got lots of produce from different parts of New Zealand.
Doesn't matter what department you're from, everybody's proud of what they do.
It's actually about stretching beyond the buildings and into the future of New Zealand.
I didn't come here to tell you how this is going to end. I came here to tell you how it's going to begin.
Let the show begin.
Shunting, you're a bad man too.
Hey! Twist it and turn.
Welcome back to the second half of the show, and put your hands together for a group you should remember their name. It's called Prestige. Wow, grand final
Where
week.
Where did those come from? Where did those guys come from?
I think
from?
They're South Waikato boys or Huntley boys, but they are incredible. Unbelievable. Big wow there. You know, grand final week is turning into a really special week, and a whole lot of things going on that the girls have had to do.
Activities. Now, a couple of nights ago, the girls waitressed at various Lone Star restaurants around Auckland. Mm-hmm. They nailed it. They absolutely nailed it. I think some of the owners would have liked to take them on.
Yeah, I know. And there was a real deal going here. The girls got tips. Yeah, they got tips. But those tips would go to the charities that Miss Universe supports. How about this? One night,
$1,000.
$1,000.
Unbelievable. $1,000 straight to charity. So after that, didn't stop. They went down to the bike barn at Britomart and had a ride on some bikes. You can see that on the screen. Look at that. They're pretty excited. Now, four of these finalists will actually take home a bike. They'll have a choice of the retro-style bike or the urban bike. Unbelievable.
Now, it's time to hold your breath. Ready? Because the judges have come to a conclusion and the public voting is all stopped. So, one thing we can tell you, it's very, very close.
So close. So close. Time now for the first elimination of the evening. We throw to the numbers man, Nigel Godfrey.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, thank you. Thank you, Sonia. Thank you, Stephen. I have here the results of the judges and the public vote combined. Now, as you've heard, all of the contestants have been competing in the entrepreneurial challenge, where they raise money for both their journey and for Variety, the children's charity. That total shows on their Everyday Hero page. This figure is then combined with any sponsors that they introduce, ticket sales through their Facebook pages, and virtual dollars awarded by Miss Universe New Zealand for outstanding effort. Now, the winner and the runner-up in the entrepreneurial challenge will receive immunity from elimination in this first cut. They will go through to our top 11. If, however, these two contestants have already made it by virtue of the judges and the public vote, then the 11th place will go to the next highest achiever in the entrepreneurial challenge, and so on. I hope you're following this at home. Now, as the elimination is announced in no particular order, the 11th name that I call will not be the 11th placed contestant, as the rankings stand at present. In the event that the winner of the entrepreneurial challenge is already in the top 11, they will receive a bonus point that can then be used by the adjudicators on their behalf as the competition progresses to later rounds. So, in no particular order, here are the top 11. It is time to start the elimination. The first girl going through to the top 11 is Ella Wilson. The next contestant through, Karishma Govind. Joining Karishma, Gabrielle Manaloto. Three contestants through so far. And now to join these three, it's the turn of Hannah Henderson. Sammy McClung. Joining Sammy and the other girls here at the front of the stage, May Barry. Just three places left, ladies and gentlemen. One of those places is going to Becky Hingston. And this is where it gets tough. All of these contestants have done a fantastic job over the last 3 months. They have been a joy to work with. This is not a part of the show I enjoy. The next person through, Rachel Anea. Squeeze up, girls. There is one more place in our top 11. And that place goes to Jordan Ratu. Ladies and gentlemen, please congratulate our top 11 and commiserate with our ladies who are leaving, whose journey is over. Let's hear it for the girls at the back as they wander from the stage. Well, ladies and gentlemen, I don't like that bit. Now, as you know, we have the entrepreneurial challenge. And now it is time to reveal who the runner-up was and who is the winner of the entrepreneurial challenge. And some great prizes, which I think have come in behind me. Here we go. We've got our bicycles here from the bike barn. The winner is going to win one of those. It's time to reveal. First up, have we got our goodie bag, please? So we've got our goodie bags. This is for the runner-up in the entrepreneurial challenge. Runner-up in the entrepreneurial challenge is standing right next to me. It's Jordan Ratu. And there are some great goodies in there. Let's bring those bikes forward. Let's bring them forward to here so we can see them. Okay. And let's bring on the trophy. And to present the trophy, the entrepreneurial challenge winner, indeed, is Prina Sena, who won the Entrepreneurial Challenge last year. So let's hear it for Prina. The winner of the Entrepreneurial Challenge. She's going to get to choose a bike. She gets this lovely trophy, and she also gets a great goodie bag. It is Ronita Lau. And you get a sash, and you can ride the bike home. Or maybe not. Ladies and gentlemen, let's hear it for Ronita, and let's hear it for all of our top 11.
Well, exciting or stomach churning? I'm so sure. But we are down to 11.
It's a hard part of the show, isn't it, that? It's very hard. It has to be done, though.
Yeah, I know. Nigel doesn't like doing that part of the show, but that's just the way it rolls. But you know what? You can understand it, Sons, when you think that having met the girls over the past, two, 3 days, you sort of understand the incredible journey that they've been on. And, well, it must be hard when it just comes to an end.
Yeah, it's tough.
Yeah.
I think now it's probably time for us to lighten the mood a little bit. Let's have some more entertainment, shall we? Get rid of the
frowny faces.
To sing for us tonight, a man who left New Zealand a few years ago, who headed to London, where he performed in Blood Brothers, The Witches of Eastwick, and ended up on the stage of the Old Witch Theatre in London's West End, where he starred for over a year as Alberto Bedini in Top Hat.
Well, now he's back here in God's own Aotearoa, New Zealand. He starred in Mamma Mia right across the country, and he trod the boards right here at Skycity last year as Edna. Edna in the hit show Hairspray. So with the Michael Bublé very appropriately titled song, I Just Haven't Met You Yet, please welcome Russell Dixon.
Surprise, not everything lasts. I've broken my heart so many times, I've stopped keeping track. Talk myself in, I talk myself out. I get all worked up, then I let myself down. I've tried so very hard not to lose it. I came up with a million excuses, and now I can see every possibility. And I know someday that it'll all turn out. You'll make me work so we can work to work it out. And I'll promise you, kid, I'll give so much more than I get. I just haven't met you yet. I might have to wait, I'll never give up. I guess it's half timing and the other half's luck. Wherever you are, whenever it's right, you'll come out of nowhere and into my life. And I know that we can be so amazing. And baby, your love is gonna change me. And now I can see every possibility. And I know someday that it'll all turn out. You make me work so we can work to work it out. And I'll promise you, kid, I'll give so much more than I get. I just haven't met you yet. They say all's fair in love and war, but I won't need to fight it. Get it right and we'll be united. And I know that we can be so amazing. And baby, your love is gonna change me. Now I can see every single possibility. And someday I know it'll all turn out. And I'll work to work it out. Promise you, kid, I'll give more than I get. Than I get, than I get, than I get. Oh, you know it'll all turn out. I just haven't met you yet. I just haven't met you yet. I said love.
Ladies and gentlemen, Russell Dixon and your top 11.
Now, I'll let you in on a little secret. Russell's also been working with us on this show as the assistant director, and you might recognise him as TV3's weatherman from a few years ago.
Gee, that's taking it way back, isn't it? But he is a man of many talents, as are Russ.
Now, the judges have been hard at work, taking the 11 down to 5. No doubt you guys have your favourites at home. Did they make it through to the top 11? Will they make it to the top 5? We are not far from finding out. In the meantime, sit back, relax, and enjoy another of our fabulous performers tonight.
Now, I heard this rehearsal. Mm. This is a special one. She was the star of the worldwide hit TV series, The Tribe. She made it through the first few cuts on both Australian Idol and New Zealand's X Factor. She now juggles three young children and a performance career. And we are delighted she is with us tonight. Get set for performing at last. Here's Meryl Cassie. Ladies and gentlemen, the incomparable Meryl Cassie. Small woman, big voice. Aye? That was impressive.
Voice like honey, isn't she?
Just like honey, silky smooth. Well, it's time for us to take a very, and I mean, don't get out of your seats break, because we're going to be back with the elimination from 11 to heartbreaking 5.
Later on, our very special tribute to the charities that Miss Universe New Zealand supports. So don't go away, you've got 3 minutes 15.
Obviously people judge a lot, but I mean, you just have to see it for yourself.
There's a lot of heart and soul and blood and sweat and tears that go into producing that service.
We got lots of produce from different parts of New Zealand.
Doesn't matter what department you're from, everybody's proud of what they do.
It's actually about stretching beyond the buildings and into the future of New Zealand.
Half price, store wide, only in Bike Bar.
Miss Universe New Zealand wishes to acknowledge the following platinum sponsors. Golden Gowns, making Miss Universe New Zealand stand out on the international stage. UFC Refresh, 100% coconut water, giving you 100% natural rehydration. UFC Refresh. We stay at the Quadrant Hotel and Suites, where style and sophistication spend the night together. Own the night with the world's best-looking champagne. It's Beaujolais pour moi. And now we'll take you back to Skycity Theatre for the Miss Universe New Zealand Grand Final 2015.
Welcome back. It's that time again. The 11 contestants are assembled behind us on the stage.
And it's time again to throw it back to our numbers man, Nigel, over to you.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's get on with it. It is time to eliminate. The top five in no particular order. Jordan Ratu. Hannah Henderson. Samantha McClung. Two places. I've memorized the names. The penultimate place goes to Becky Hinkston. There's one place left. And that place goes to Gabrielle Manoloto. Ladies and gentlemen, it is a supreme effort to get this far. Put your hands together for our top five and for those who are leaving the competition.
Thank you, Nigel. Well, there they are, our top five. And of course, we've said goodbye to those whose journey has ended. Now, I don't know about you, but we've just seen these young women in swimwear and evening wear. But you know what? I'd like to meet them. So, let's hear from Jordan. Where's Jordan? Wow. You're in the top five. What's going through your head right now?
A lot. I can't even comprehend it. I'm very stoked and happy.
How difficult, how exciting, and how much support have you had through this?
So much support, as you can hear in the front.
What would it mean to win?
It would mean a lot to win. It would be excellent. Just put the icing on the top of the cake for me.
All right, congratulations. Go back to your spot. You're in the top five. Hannah. Hey, Hannah. How are you feeling right now?
I'm pretty overwhelmed and really excited, and I can catch my breath now instead of holding it.
Gee, you do all right for overwhelmed. Catch you. All right, what's been the most inspiring thing about this journey for you?
I think all of the girls, every single one of them are different, and all the energy that they bring and the commitment and courage, I think that's one of the most inspiring things when you're feeling quite nervous. The journey's really hard and they've been great.
All right, good answer. Take your place. Congratulations, Hannah. Samantha. You had a little moment back there in the evening where a bit of a nail. You came through okay. That must have given you a lot of confidence.
Luckily I was able to actually bend down and take the nail out, so that was quite, I was very happy about that.
Tell me about the Philippines experience, because from where we were sitting watching that wonderful Philippines travel doco, it just looked spectacular.
It was. I'd actually never been overseas apart from being in Australia, so seeing the Philippines was very eye-opening. It is a beautiful place and I'd love to go back.
Well, maybe you will as Miss Universe New Zealand 2015. We'll just have to wait and see. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Becky. Come on, Becky. Becky's been standing in the wings watching everybody like a little five-year-old, having so much fun. Have you been having fun?
I have been, and that prestige dance was just getting everyone so excited backstage.
It was very cool. They are very good lads. What would it mean to you to be crowned Miss Universe New Zealand 2015?
I probably couldn't even put it into words. This is my second time in the competition, and to be crowned Miss Universe New Zealand would be a dream come true.
Why are you getting all nervous? You better go back and take your spot. Congratulations, you're in the top five. And finally, Gabby. Well, we saw you yesterday heading out the lifts. We thought you were going for a run. Did you actually go for a run at all?
Absolutely not.
Come on, we're in the modern age, you're supposed to have gone for a run. Okay, let's talk about hanging around all these other young ladies and contestants. And what have you learned about yourself? Because we always, you know, you look around and say, oh, those girls, they're the competition. But what have you learned about you?
About me? Well, just working alongside these young women, don't forget where you come from. So when I was on stage today, and I made eye contact with my mother, and she gave me the thumbs up, I felt pretty accomplished, so...
What's it like having your mum here and the family support?
I felt even more nervous. I thought I was going to be more nervous in front of the judges, but my family's approval means a lot to me.
So you're in the top five now. How nervous are you now?
I can hear my heart louder than my voice.
That'll do me. Congratulations, Gabby. You are in the top five. Well, there you have it. And who would have wanted to make that call, and who is going to represent New Zealand and the USA later this year? This, of course, is up to the judges and you at home.
And this is the way it works. The top five have been ranked. Places five and four will stand. The judges are then given the top three in no particular order, and they will decide who will become Miss Universe New Zealand 2015.
When we come back, a very special tribute to the charities that Miss Universe New Zealand supports, and then we will find out who will be crowned Miss Universe New Zealand 2015. Don't move.
Get your happy dance on with Half Price, Store White or Bike Barn this Labour weekend. That's Half Price on road bikes, bike accessories, mountain bikes and Half Price kids bikes. Half Price, Store White, only in Bike Barn.
Prize consideration for Miss Universe New Zealand 2015, proudly provided by Honda, Bench, Bike Barn, Bourgeois Champagne, Fujifilm Instax, Somala Professional Cosmetics, Jewels by Aqua, Go Healthy, Sunkissed Tan, Oasis Beauty, Audio Technica, Thai Chef's Restaurants, UFC Refresh, and Manuka Doctor. Miss Universe New Zealand thanks all our product and prize sponsors for their generous support.
Obviously, people judge a lot, but I mean, you just have to see it for yourself.
There's a lot of heart and soul and blood and sweat and tears that go into producing that service.
We got lots of produce from different part of New Zealand.
Doesn't matter what department you're from, everybody's proud of what they do.
It's actually about stretching beyond the buildings and into the future of New Zealand.
You're watching the Miss Universe New Zealand Grand Final 2015, live from Skycity Theatre.
You're watching the Miss Universe New Zealand 2015 from the Skycity Theatre. Now, as you know, each year they do an entrepreneurial challenge, and the 50% of the money they raise goes towards our special charity, which is very cool, and that is Variety, the children's charity. How about this? This year, our contestants raised $35,000. Yeah, that's worth a round of applause, I think. More importantly, since Miss Universe New Zealand was relaunched a couple of years ago, all the contestants have raised $75,000, and that really does make a difference.
That's a huge difference. So, with a very special tribute to Variety and Tahanan in Manila, which Miss Universe New Zealand now also supports, here are some familiar faces. You'll recognise these guys with a particularly beautiful rendition of Tomorrow. Take it away.
Tomorrow, bet your bottom dollar that tomorrow there'll be some.
Oh, just thinking about tomorrow. Clears away the cobwebs and the sorrow.
When I'm stuck with the day that's gray and lonely, I just pick up my chin and grin and say, the sun will come out tomorrow, so you gotta hang on till tomorrow.
Meryl Cassie and Nigel Godfrey.
And let's not, of course, forget the Philippians. And you know the one thing about all this? Tomorrow, one of these young ladies will wake up as Miss Universe New Zealand 2015. Well, you know what? I don't know where the time's gone, but that just about wraps it up from us. And what a night it has been. You and... Yes, we've met some fantastic young women. If you and I have been inspired...
I think they're looking at the throne.
The throne. Yes, to enter the competition. Then registration is now open for 2016.
All you have to do, if you feel like entering, and look at these guys, the experience they've had, you'd be silly not to. You head to the website, nextmissnz.com, and fill out your details. And then you too could be winging your way to the Philippines on retreat as a finalist next year.
Hang on a minute. Just slow the horse down. We haven't found out who's actually won this year. And that person, of course, will be heading to the United States of America for the international final on December 20 for Miss Universe.
Wow.
Yeah,
of course, we can't go without mentioning the prizes once again. The top three will receive a brand new bike from the Bike Barn. All our contestants receive a mix of jewellery, cosmetics, health products, and our judges and entertainers and hosts receive a pretty special goodie bag. We do. I've got mine in
okay.
my dressing room.
You've left something out. There is the big one.
And the big one, yes.
There's the Honda Jazz RS Sport Limited Edition. Now, they talk about it being the power of dreams. And that's what Honda's tagline. Well, someone's dream will come true because they'll also wake up with the keys. It's sitting at the base of the Sky Tower right now. That key will be handed over after the show. And Miss Universe New Zealand 2015 will be in the driving seat of her lovely Honda RS Jazz for the year of her reign.
Oh, it's a good gig, isn't it?
It's not a bad gig. Great car, bud.
Do make sure you download the souvenir program from our website as all of our sponsors and supporters feature. And we couldn't do the show without them. We couldn't do it.
Okay, heavy heart time. Our job is done. It's time for us to hand over to the last time, to the man with the numbers. And these are very important numbers. Nigel, it's all yours.
Well, just before you throw it over to me, ladies and gentlemen, we could not do the show without our two fabulous hosts. Please give it up for Stephen McIvor and Sonia Gray. I will now announce the results in reverse order. In fifth place, Jordan Ratu! In fourth place, Becky Hinkston. Becky's second time in Miss Universe New Zealand, made the top five last year as well. Now it's the business end, ladies and gentlemen. In third place, Gabrielle Manoloto. Ladies and gentlemen, we are left with just two contestants. In the event that the winner cannot, for any reason, fulfill her duties, then the runner-up will take over. The next name that I announce will be the winner of Miss Universe New Zealand 25. Or even 2015. Miss Universe New Zealand 2015 is... Samantha McClung! Miss Universe New Zealand 2015. Let's hear it for all of our top five.